the Rambam in the Laws of Repentance, chapter 2, Halacha 2. The Rambam writes, "Umay Tshuva? How do you define Tshuva? How do you define repentance? She'azov achote chet'o ve'yasiro mimachshavto." That the sinner would leave his sin and will clean it from his mind. Ve'igmor belibo shelo ya'aseu hod. Three steps. First, to leave the sin. Second, erase it from your head. I don't want to even think about it. I'm ashamed that I used to do these things. Tov. And I accept on myself never to do these horrible sins against Hashem ever again. No. Is that enough? No. Comes the fourth step. What's the fourth step? Ve'yayid alav yodea ta'alumot. The one that knows all the mysteries and all the secrets, Hashem, will testify on that person shelo yashuv lezeh achet leolam. That after you say, I'm sorry for what I've done, I'm never going to do it again, I erase it from my mind, I accept never to go back to this bad, horrible sin, averot, and Hashem say, he's sincere, he's serious, he's not a scammer. And Hashem said, put his stamp on it. I know this person is serious. What do you think? It happens overnight? Huh? Yesterday you started to be Shomer Shabbat, and right away Hashem give you a stamp. Oh, he will never be Mechalel Shabbat again. Baloney. Takes sometimes years. If you go to yeshiva, 2-3 months, that's it. You never go back to your evil way. Because now you understand what the Torah is. Problem with people is that they don't understand what the Torah is. How do you know what the Torah is? You know how do you know what the Torah is? You speak to someone that gave his life for the Torah and never stopped a minute to give his entire mind and soul into Hashem's Torah. Who was like that? In our generation, he passed 60 years ago approximately. The Chazon Ish. The Chazon Ish. One of the biggest rabbis ever lived. Definitely one of the biggest in the last 100 years. He knew the whole Torah. His language is like 1,000 years old language. It doesn't belong to today's world. The language that he has, you can see right away, is neshama that comes 1 out of 1 billion. 1 out of 1 billion, you have somebody like that. I wanna read to you what the Chazon Ish said. Aish azoche leyediyat haTorah, person that reached a level after decades, tens of years, to finally know the Torah, that you can say he knows Torah. Not he knows few masachtot. No, he knows the whole Torah. Every subject. Hu olech ben anashim, he walks in the street, he's on the way to synagogue or to yeshiva. Walks in the street. Venidme la'adam haroe la'inayim keben adam. People that look at him, they look at him like another human being. It's another person walking in the street of Bnei Brak or Yerushalayim. Aval be'emet hu malach hagar im bnei tmuta. Everyone else are people. They one day will die and that's it. How much they're going to take out of this world? Not that much. But that person is not a human being anymore. He's an angel. V'chai chaye atzilut u'merumam al bracha u'teila. The Chazon Ish continue, the obligation of every Jew is to know the entire Shas, to know the whole Gemara. It takes many years to learn it. If you're a genius, 7 years you learn, you know Baruch Hashem, what is it about? If you continue to learn after 30, 40 years, you know the whole Shas. Baki b'chol ha-Shas. Like Rav Chaim Kanievsky, Rav Ben Zion Abba Shaul, Rav Ovadia, Rav Eliashiv, Rav Vozner, Rav Karelitz. These are people who know the Shas. Mi she'eno yodea, someone who doesn't care. He's busy with soccer games, with tennis, with comedy, and all kinds of things. What is he? When he comes to Olam Haba, they will have a huge complaint against him. Yalkuhu! They'll be very upset with him in the court of heaven. Someone who had Shas in his place, meaning he had the books. When all these people didn't have books, there was printing was rare, not like today, you have pay $20 a book and you get it. Ikar Sgulat HaTorah, the main thing, the ability of the Torah is to make the human being, להביא את האדם לרוממות עילאה, to lift his spirit to the highest level, ולהכיר את חובתו בעולמו. The more Torah you learn, the more it clears to you what's the purpose of your life. People sometimes ask me, Rabbi, how someone like me will know the purpose of his life? I don't know if to laugh in their face or not. Someone like you will know his purpose of his life. How are you going to know? Do you learn Torah? You know all the rules. You know the principles. You know the secrets. You don't know. How are you going to know? It's like me operating on someone's heart without learning medicine. I'm not a medical doctor. So someone asks me, how do I operate on my cousin? His heart is in a critical condition. I would like to operate in open heart surgery, doctor. Can you tell me how can I operate on him? The doctor would laugh in your face. You know. Normal, what do you mean how you operate? You go to medical school, after 10 years you come back. You practice with a great surgeon for a few years, and then after that you'll do your own operations. Same thing over here. You learn and learn and learn. The more you learn, the more the picture becomes clear. Mishpatei Hashem emet, tzadeku yachdav. Once a person realizes what's the obligation that Hashem expects from him in his world, and he comes only with Amal HaTorah, with devotion to Torah and hard work, ככל שהאדם מוסיף בהגיעתו, the more efforts you put into it, מנתק בזה את חבלי היצר. The more you kill your evil inclination. There's no way to kill the evil inclination unless you shakua, you're sinking deeply into Torah and it becomes your entire life. וממאס בתענוגי האבלים. He has zero attraction to physical pleasures and attractions of this world. He doesn't care about Six Flags and about the Bahamas and about the yacht. None of these things. That shows you what kind of losers we are. Because we do care about these things. Someone that cares about what kind of watch he's going to buy and he gets so excited, it shows you that he's an empty mind. Did you ever see a real legendary holy rabbi that cares about the watch? Or cares about the brand of his suit? Or cares about what food you're going to give him? Give him potato every day. Potato with bread. He will eat potato with bread. That's it, just to survive. Anyway, these things do not concern him. Nothing. Ask the boys in my yeshiva in Yerushalayim, who is the prime minister? They don't know. Promise you, it's no exaggeration. You're going to my yeshiva, ask them, who's the prime minister right now? They don't know. They're disconnected from the news. They don't have smartphones, they don't have internet, they don't have none, they don't have TV, nothing, no computer, no nothing. Ask him, who's the minister of defense? No idea. What happened yesterday in Lebanon? They have no idea. Who's Nasrallah? They don't have any idea. They don't have any idea. Sometimes I go to my cousin and I tell him about things that happen. When I came one time, first time, to tell him that the prime minister sued me and this, he didn't know who he is. Who is he? What is he? So, no, he was the prime minister. What? Yeah, this, that, nothing. It's not, after first 5 minutes to explain to him how he became prime minister, the scammer, the traitor, without that he had no idea what's going on. Why? Because their entire mind goes to Torah. Once your mind is in heaven, why would you want to get out of there for a minute? And that's what people don't understand. That's why when they look from the outside and those who learn Torah, what kind of life is this? The question should have been the opposite. What kind of life you have? But, you know.